Hi there, I'm Leah and I am with Ruby May Jewelry and I am going to get started taking buttons and things out of this vintage picnic basket. It is a metal red tin, I guess you would call it, and I'll show you the lid. So it's this kind of a lid. It's rusted and dirty. And I think this basket probably weighs about 20 pounds with everything inside of it. I got it at an estate sale and I'm ready to go through it. I've got a show coming up in a couple weeks and I'd like to take it all out, sort it, bag it, price it, research it, and get it ready for sale. So the first thing that's in this basket is this very large Ziploc bag. I'm gonna set that aside for now and we'll come back to it once the basket has emptied. So buttons on cards typically do not have a high resale. Some people like them, some people don't, but depending on the card is whether I keep them all together or not. So I'm just going to pull the cards out and set them aside. I like these little pearl buttons. They were used for sweaters and blouses and wedding dresses and things like that. Some wood buttons. Typical of people from the era of probably the 40s and 50s is probably where this basket came from. They like to gather and keep anything and everything that could possibly be reused again. They were the original upcycle generation. So what's here are plastic white buttons, probably from doll clothes or children's clothes. And I will just leave those in the box together. Oh, just some, looks like wool-covered blue buttons that probably came with clothing. Now, that is a really lovely card, this gal. I will leave those buttons on that card. It says Glamour Girl, probably a 10 for 10 cents. But somebody would like to have that. Just some plastic buttons. It's a really nice large button. The gals that do knitting and crochet like these great big buttons. Two broken buttons. That's a nice big buckle. That is a mother of pearl shell button. Some plastic buttons. Silver buttons are a little bit harder color to come by, so I'll probably pull that one off the card. Snaps, I'll leave those on the card. Somebody might want just that. That's an interesting buckle. It says latest novelty fashion. I'll leave that one on the card as well. Nice size button. Those are plastic. So that's interesting. That has the initials MP. It is a metal button, but it doesn't have a shank on the back side. I wonder if that is homemade. So the items I find are kind of interesting and cool I will set aside, which I will do with the MP button. Those are glass. So let's see what's in it. It says white buttons. And they are all white buttons. So there's some mother of pearl, some plastic. I will leave that little tribe all together. Sweater buttons. So these are interesting. Their faces, look like they're copper. I believe these are handmade from Mexico. They don't belong with this card. So these are handmade from Mexico. And those are an interesting find. Let's see if you can see their face. So these are rhinestone buttons, or what they call paste. These are some of my favorites, are the rhinestone buttons. Few of them are missing stones. I'm having an issue with my other cameras. That's why I am not on camera today. I'm sorry about that. Some purple plastic. Button covers. Large leather. Those are probably for coats or sweaters. Some wood buttons. So here is a button that matched that buckle. So that's interesting. So that could have been a homemade button. Set those two aside in case we find more. Pink plastic. Those are pretty. Those have a little, they're plastic, but they have a paste in the middle and a gold rim. Orange plastic. Okay, I'm gonna move this tray aside and use another tray. Okay, let's see what's in this case. So that's a leather button. Probably a uniform button. So here's matching buttons that probably all came off a sweater. Kind of a dragon emblem on it. A Girl Scout pin. That's a keeper. Oops, I got it upside down. There it is. A Girl Scout pin. You do get bits of pieces of people's lives when you go through these and see what kind of work buttons they had, or uniform buttons. This is a cufflink. It's a plastic cufflink. I really like these little pearl buttons. This one's a little bit damaged, but pearls just kind of soften jewelry when you add them. It's a cloth button with kind of an interesting design. I'm gonna look in there and see if there's any more Girl Scout items to put together. Don't really see anything else in there very unusual. Large buttons. I do really appreciate this red navy button with the anchor. Plastic buckle. A couple more anchor buttons. This yellow flower, that's might be early plastic, that might be from the 30s. Pick out the buckles, the large buttons. So that is a bottle of Balenciaga perfume. It says Paris, France. I'm gonna smell it. Okay, it totally smells good. Put that over there with my interesting finds. I have never before found perfume in a button tin, so that's a first. Okay, I'm just going to thumb through these. These are all on the lid of a... I do like seeing thumbnails, thimbles. Sea spear and you'll see. Sea spear and you'll see. So that was some kind of advertisement for something. Interesting. An acorn button. That is just so sweet. Okay, this is a little, I think that is a dachshund. Maybe it came out of a gumball machine? I'm not quite sure. It's green and it's plastic. This shamrock, is that what that is? That has damage, so I will pull that aside and see if it can be cleaned. I love a big pearl button. This is black glass. When Queen Victoria went into mourning in the 1860s, black glass became very fashionable, and that's what everybody was wearing. This is from lingerie, that buckle. This little pearl one is sweet. Celluloid buttons will continue to degrade and will start to crumble and affect the surrounding buttons. And so these button tins tend to get very dirty and dusty feeling inside. Do not know what that is for. Oh, that's actually a button. That's cool. I do like this red one. I think that'll be fun hanging off the end of a bracelet. This is an infected button. Do you see how that's decaying and it's clinging to another one? So that will get pulled out of the tribe. It says ideal on it. Another buckle. Gold with a fake paste and rhinestone on the inside. It's interesting, the other bucket I had one of these buttons in it. It kind of has some interesting detail on the inside. Kind of a pinwheel effect. These ones in plastic, these are leather, probably all from one coat. Empty jar. So this, I do love a big rhinestone. I think those are fun. Plastic, plastic, some kind of clip, buckle, thimble, let's see. So brass buttons, this has a profile of someone on it. I do like profiles. I might have enough men to do a whole bracelet of men. Crowns and shields. So I'll set the man aside. It does not feel like a really old button. Maybe from the 60s. The last basket I went through had jewelry in it, which was so interesting and fun to find. A bunch of plastics from the 50s and 60s. This is adorable, this red and black check. With the stars around it, that is Air Force. That's an Air Force military button. Oh, that's a piece of jewelry. Has an art deco feel to it. I don't know if it is. Just a couple little pink buttons in there. Do you like the jar? Just some little pearl buttons and some hooks to hang curtains. Another Air Force button. A lot of plastic. Pearl. It's missing a stone. It's a great big button. That's a celluloid button. You can tell by the shank, it's got a hump shank on the back. See the broken pieces here? That is crumbling. This is like a pocket toothpick. You would carry this around to have a toothpick. It feels like it is made from a bone or shell. So that is super interesting, and I'll definitely have to research that. More cards and bags. Plastic. Really nice, great big buttons. No doubt that those three were on an overcoat. And then that would have been up at the collar. These are pretty. They have like a little flower on them. They're silver. filling up that tray as well. I'm pretty sure this bucket weighed about 25 pounds. I was at an estate sale after the Women's March in downtown Phoenix, and I stopped in and I said, "Do you have any vintage buttons?" And they said, "No, we gave them all to the Button Society." I said, "Oh, well, that's good." And then a teenager walked out with the first basket, and then he came out with the second basket. So, hallelujah. That is an unusual button. Kind of got this gold dome on it. My friend Nancy loves all these plastic buttons. Well, not all of them, but she's got a... Okay, let's do another tray. To my other two cameras today. They just don't want to participate. So they got left out. That little hook is interesting. Don't have any idea what that was used for. It doesn't look strong enough to be a shoe hook, but it's possible. I'm gonna zip through these because I can see that it's just mostly all plastic. That is super interesting. I've never seen that button before. So it's a clock. It's an inexpensive button. It's just a, you know, plastic. But it's interesting. I'll stand up to do this. This one says M and O. Let's see if I can put a magnifier on it. M and D. It does have some damage down here on the bottom, some rust, but I might take a pencil eraser to that and see if I can't clean that up. M and O. Yeah, I think that's M and O. Look, the back is destroyed though. So, it's not very salvageable. Here's another one of those green buttons that matches the belt buckle. It's an eagle charm. It's very sweet. Another one of those green buttons.
button that's destroyed. So, if you ever come upon a button tin, be sure to rescue it. They get pitched in the dumpster, and people don't realize the history of them. And, you know, they could be up to 100 years old, passed down through family generations. So you want to keep them where people can play with them. I often recommend that people put them all in a jar on their coffee table and let people go through them when they sit in their living room. Most people have great memories about buttons, playing with them at their grandmother's house. Another thimble. That is a glass button.
That is a very lovely button.
Button I did previously was the button box. It had a lot of cufflinks in it. That's a cute button. Piece of jewelry. I do like the red balls. I think those are fun. Another thimble. Well, this is my favorite button so far. It's heavy, domed, it's in great shape, and it's full of rhinestones. Remember, we saw that on a button card earlier. This is a pot metal that was full of paste buttons. It's very old. That's probably from the 50s, but it's missing a few stones. Trays are running out of room. Let me get another tray. Red, white, and blue from the 70s. I've made a few red, white, and blue necklaces. I might just set that aside and throw that on one. Looking at the bottom. Okay, let's see what's in this tub. Right away, it just looks like more of the same. I do like seeing the cloth covered buttons and the fabric from the, you know, 50s and 60s. The star's cute. So here's a couple of interesting ones. That is mirror. So that's a little bit of a cracked mirror button. And this is a glass button. You can tell, see that? This button is infected, so we'll pull it out from the tribe. Oh, I gotta share that the last basket I went through actually had a mourning button in it, and a mourning button was around the 1860s, late 1800s, and that is human hair within the button, and that's what they did to remember their loved ones. They created jewelry, buttons, brooches, pins, watches, rings, things, bracelets with human hair. So that was a very interesting find. Okay, so this is a celluloid button, and it is breaking down and will start to begin to crumble and affect the other buttons around it. So I will pull that button out of the rotation. They're just metal buttons. Oh, lovely. It's a cross. I'm guessing this was a bookmarker. I believe that's what's called buffed celluloid. They look like little faces. Oh my gosh, that's a big thimble. That's a big one. It's got stars on it. Another one of the green. See the damage on this one? I'll pull it out. I do like these little buckles. I do add them to a bracelet. It is a jar of plastic buttons. Okay, they're all stuck together. So it looks like one of them melted and stuck together. So in the Arizona heat, if this was up in an attic, you could see how that could happen. I once had my snow globe at Christmas time up in the attic, and it all melted during the summer and exploded and molded all my Christmas items. You gotta be careful with Arizona heat. Is infected. That's a nice big button. Right now I'm going to look through and see if I see any more infected ones to pull out. This is a gold tone thimble. It's little, needs washing. since we've gone through all of these, let's go through what was in that bag. I'm gonna dump it out. And we'll see. Just some thread, button covers, some more buttons on cards, felt flowers, looks like maybe homemade felt flowers. They're darling. Probably hand painted wood beads, buttons, all red together. Orange together, orange and leather. Oh, I spot something fun. Bowling pin. Those are cute. They kind of go with these ones, don't they? Okay, so this is a clasp for a like a belt. Made in Czechoslovakia, so that's glass. Another lovely lady button card. This is all white together. I am not sure what that was used for. It looks like a little barbell. It's cute. Oh, somebody separated out all the white. Infected. Red, white, and blue. More of the painted wood. She's lovely. And that looks like it. I think we did it. I want to show you some of the treasures. These are some of my favorites. And you would just never know that all of this was in that button tin. Oh, and we can't forget the perfume, Balenciaga. So that's it for this show. Thanks for watching, and I appreciate you tuning in.